As we struggle to deal with the COVID-19 crisis, governments around the world are forced to adopt new technologies and systems in order to protect their populations. Artificial intelligence has proved highly effective in aiding governments as diverse as South Korea and Germany. In this video, we highlight how AI and machine learning are being used to fight the virus. AI is being used to accelerate the development of vaccines by analyzing prior data on similar diseases such as SARS, and then using this data to help researchers answer some of the critical questions faster, speeding up the process of finding a cure and also making treatment more efficient. Speeding up diagnosis and treatment. Health centers are using AI-integrated X-ray scanning systems, which can automatically detect the virus using image recognition. Streamlining payment. Post-treatment, which includes post-care and insurance payments, can be streamlined using AI and vastly streamlining the processes. Enabling data processing. Regulators and government agencies collect, make available, and process data across multiple organizations and departments. They are using AI to open up to a larger audience of scientists and researchers who can use that data to improve the impact of medicines and forecast future pandemics. With the help of mobile apps, holistic self-diagnosis can be implemented as users are integrated into an ecosystem of vast data and information. Mobile apps will help identify patient risk level, utilizing location data to map out who coronavirus carriers have come into contact with and create chains of individuals with identifiable levels of risk. You can imagine a situation where, if a confirmed patient's mobile location is known at all times, then it's possible to identify all of the other people that this patient came into contact with in a matter of minutes. And subsequently, all those people also came into contact with. This allows you to determine people who have likely been infected in order to test and isolate before they infect others. The first report of an impending biohazard was discovered through AI-powered systems that combed through animal and plant disease networks, information from vernacular websites, government documents, and other data pulling sources. There are two main types of data. One is textual data, and COVID-19 includes over 24,000 technical articles and data about adverse effects. The other type of data is numerical data, which includes information on how the virus spreads and is being treated, with data constantly being added each of these data sets. Textual data is particularly difficult to meaningfully utilize. This is due to the difficulty in processing all of the literature to extract the critical information. To try and make sense of the data, natural language processing, or NLP, a branch of AI, is being applied on this vast dataset to extract useful information about the virus. NLP can use the textual data to analyze and understand the development of the virus and help develop a vaccination faster. Numerical data, by its nature, is more precise and structured. There are two primary ways numerical data can be used by machine learning tools. The first is classification, and the second, prediction. Classification allows us to find clusters and to identify patterns in the data. For example, what are the characteristics of people who initially contracted the disease? And are there groups who appear more susceptible to the virus than others? Using predictive models, we're able to estimate which health centers are likely to be overwhelmed so that we can prepare adequate resources ahead of time. The application of artificial intelligence and machine learning tools has vastly improved our ability to combat COVID-19. The virus and ensuing crisis has highlighted the various ways AI and machine learning can be used to benefit society, whether that be in combating a global pandemic or simply finding the most effective way to improve the quality of life. Click the subscribe button for more on artificial intelligence and machine learning, and to learn how they can benefit industry, government, and society at large.